pop the blooming champagne, blow those party horns, ding dong, the mosquitoes are dead. Would anyone be sad about this? Would there be wider repercussions? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that loves a deep dive into a plethora of topics from science to science fiction, history, pop culture, and good old-fashioned what-ifs. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if mosquitoes went extinct? Anyone sad about it? Raise your hand. Oh, that's what I thought. Before we get into this video, I want to share a story. A few weeks ago, I went to a place called Peely Island in Canada. I had a lovely time, except for the fact that I got absolutely savagely eaten alive by mosquitoes, and I'm talking true savage here. Luckily, the bites have now just about gone, but the memories will live and haunt me forever, and I feel like I have a personal vendetta against the, well, I can't use the word that I want to use for mosquitoes on this channel because it's family friendly, but it doesn't mean I can't think it. And trust me, I am thinking it hard. Do mosquitoes love you as much as they love my sweet, sweet blood? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you like our content, please do show me by leaving a thumbs up on this video and sharing it with a friend. Stick around to the end because I'm going to be responding to some comments. Okay, mosquitoes. Most of us in our right mind would be vehemently and actively opposed to genocide. Until it comes to mosquitoes, anyway. Then we're pretty cool with it. Kill them. Kill them all. I personally think eliminate them, but actually, do I even know what I'm encouraging? What would happen? Mosquitoes spread some horrifying diseases, such as West Nile virus, Zika, dengue fever, chikungunya, and malaria. Thing is, though, a small minority of them give the rest a bad name. Ain't that always the truth? Not all mosquitoes are vampires. There are 3,500 species of them, and most of them are plant-based. Good on them. There are only around 200 species of mosquitoes that suck human blood and spread their nasties. The rest are actually kind of helpful. The elephant mosquito, for example, kill other mosquitoes, many of which are baddies. Although, if there were no mosquitoes, then it wouldn't really matter to us whether the elephant mozzies went extinct or not. So what do we even need the non-awful mosquitoes for anyway? Their larvae do help keep water clean, but so do a bunch of other organisms, so really it wouldn't be a huge loss if they all died. Adult mosquitoes, however, are eaten by more important creatures. Fish, frogs, salamanders, lizards, Venus blooming fly traps. They love a mosquito lunch. Ooh, and our mates the dragonfly. They get them gone. If we remove a food source for these valuable creatures, they will start to get pretty hungry, which could mean their own population dwindles, which then could mean that the population of their predators dwindles too. It's a butterfly effect that could have a real impact on the ecosystem. But I have to say, by and large, the only place that it would have a real impact would be the Arctic, where the mozzies do have a significant impact on native birds. The Arctic mosquitoes pop up in the summer months, actually aren't the type to hurt humans and spread disease, so basically, we could just leave them be. Can we just kill the rest of them though? Well, mosquitoes do also pollinate plants, although not solely. Plants pollinated by mosquitoes don't rely on just them. However, if mosquitoes did go extinct, then it would have quite an impact on the orchid plants. Orchids versus millions of human lives. Really, the issue when it comes to mosquitoes comes back to those 200 nasty species. These are the Aedes genus, the Anopheles genus, and the Culex genus. These mosquitoes vector disease, meaning that harmful pathogens are absorbed in the mosquito's body and then they multiply, becoming stronger. These are, to downplay it, a real issue. Vector-borne diseases account for more than 17% of all infectious diseases in the world and cause between 700,000 to a million deaths each year. Of this, roughly half of these deaths are from malaria, which mostly kills children under 5. And that's just the death toll. Some people do just get really, really sick. 200 million people get malaria each year and are incapacitated in nasty ways for days and can feel the repercussions for years. It seems that 3.9 billion people in over 128 countries are at risk of contracting dengue fever, with 96 million cases estimated every year. Can we even get our heads around that? The most at risk from mosquitoes are people living in sub-Sahara Africa, where malaria is most prevalent. But people are at risk of sickness in general in a lot of places in the world. Most of those truly affected by mosquitoes are people with poor access to healthcare. If mosquitoes went extinct, okay, sure, the ecosystem would be a bit out of whack and orchid plants may start to go extinct, but ultimately, millions of human lives would be saved, especially in developing nations. Without the public health crisis, crisis, South American countries and African countries may have a better chance of developing. So can humans even kill mosquitoes anyway? Well, that is where things get tricky. In the past, we have conducted aerial sprays to decrease the mosquito population, but by doing so, we have exposed people and wildlife to some pretty intense chemicals, some of which can play havoc with asthma. Spraying can kill honeybees, for example, which actually is a real issue. Plus, it can kill spiders and even some fish. That being said, if proper measures are taken, it can be effective in some places, but couldn't go as far as to kill them all. Other ways scientists are looking to control mosquito populations is by releasing sterile male mosquitoes for females to attempt to breed with. Females, by the way, are the issue. Other ways they're trying to control mosquito population is by manipulating the sex of mosquitoes, which can be done, but is a lengthy process, and you can read about it all for yourself in the Forbes article that I've linked in the description box down below. So what do you think? Have you ever been bitten by a mosquito? Do they love your blood? Have you ever got really sick by a mosquito? Let me know your stories in the comments section down below. Would you, like me, not be that sad if they died? I feel like I want to hear what you have to say. Before I go, I'm going to read some comments from What If the Ark of Covenant Was Real? A lot of you had a lot of opinions. Jonathan Fletcher said, I have faith in lawyers being able to negotiate some of the terms of the Ten Commandments. If they can get OJ off murder, they can do anything. That made me laugh out loud. You can't hear me because I've already read the comments, so I knew that was coming, but the first time I read it, I was like, ha-ha-ha. Disco Saturn, such a good and lengthy username, they wrote, if we open the Ark of Covenant right in front of us, we're really gonna melt like the Nazis in the Raiders of the Lost Ark. You know what? I feel like Indiana Jones is where the real tea and truths are. It would be just like that. Adam British said, have you guys done an LBQ about Jupiter running into Earth? I don't know if something cool would happen, since Jupiter is gassy and liquidy, and all of it would do the same thing as any other rocket planet. I don't know if something cool would happen, since Jupiter is gassy and liquidy, or if it would do the same thing as any other rocky planet. Maybe Jupiter would just absorb the Earth to its center and keep on going. Thanks for the videos. Oh my goodness, what a question. Should we start smashing planets together in theory now? I feel like we could do it, actually. Maybe we'll do it. Like, actually, seriously. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to leave me your thoughts in the comments section down below. If you want to read more about the sources that went into making this video, then check out our description box. You can also find links to everyone who went into making this video possible. For now though, thank you for watching this video. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next one, but until then, please do stay curious, wear bug spray, and never ever stop questioning.